From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Dave Guthrow.
And I'm Tama Ponton. U.S. Senate candidate Benjamin Pollard has missed the deadline to file a campaign finance report.
Federal campaign regulators say that report was due on May 31st. Now, Pollard, who works full-time as a carpenter, is one of four Democratic candidates that will be on the ballot in Tuesday's primary. Yesterday, he acknowledged failing to file the report and said he will try to fill it out today. Pollard said it only involves $600 to $700 in contributions and spending.
A new report from the Maine Citizens for Clean Elections show millions of dollars are being used in campaigns here in Maine from Legislative Political Action Committees, or PACs. The report found while most individual campaigns are funded by small donations, legislative PACs have distributed more than $12 million in Maine in the past decade. The political action committees are legal, but Maine Citizens for Clean Elections say the numbers show the influence of special interest in Maine politics.
Meanwhile, officials at Kaplan University will announce more about a multi-million dollar plan to expand to a third location here in Maine. A spokesman for the university tells News 8 the details of the expansion will be released at the university's commencement ceremony today. Kaplan has campuses in South Portland and downtown Lewiston. Governor LePage will be delivering the commencement address to the university's 364 graduates. Well, if you're a national park fanatic or you're looking to get out and enjoy that beautiful day, today is a great day to do it.
Today, June 9th, is National Get Outdoors Day. Many national parks that normally offer an entrance fee will offer free admission. National Get Outdoors Day is sponsored by nonprofit organizations, federal agencies, and the recreation industry, and was created to see more people trying out traditional or non-traditional outdoor activities. There are more than 130 events planned today across America. Well, people and their pets will be walking for a good cause today.
News 8's Norm Karkos has more from Portland's Payson Park.
This is Norm Karkos here in Portland at Payson Park. Just an absolutely beautiful Saturday morning as we're gearing up for the 21st annual Pets and People Walk. This, of course, benefits the Center for Grieving Children. All proceeds go to them. Part of their core program includes a bereavement peer support in Portland and Sanford, bringing together children, teens, parents, young adults, and adults, all of whom have experienced the death of someone close to them. So bring your favorite furry four-legged friend here, and regardless, and walk around the back home. It's going to be a great day. Our very own Aaron O'Valley is going to help kick off the festivities. You can come by and register, and of course, the actual walk begins at 10 o'clock this morning here along the back cove. We are in Payson Park this morning for this event. I'm Norm Karkos, News 8.
All right. Should be a beautiful day. Thank you so much, Norm. We want to thank you for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Dave Guthrow.
And I'm Tama Ponton. Stay with us and we'll bring you the latest forecast and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.